Hi, I'm Tuhin from Overdrive, and we're at the launch of the new XUV 500 facelift. So we'll start with what's changed for this car. As you can see, the front grille is new. It has a new LED light strip, and the headlamps as well seem to are reprofiled. They're a slightly different shape. And this shade is a new shade of copper. And there's two new shades, so this is one of them. The other one is right behind, it's a dark red shade. Another major change is this new alloy wheel. It's a diamond cut design this time around. It's 18 inches, so it's not like an upsize, but it's a new design. Other than that, the side profile remains more or less similar. It's pretty much exactly the same. As we go to the rear of the car, we can see that the head tail lamps are completely new. They've now this triangular sort of shape, much better looking than the last edition of it, and it now sort of juts into the tailgate as well, so you have a fresher design to the rear as well. Other than that, there's not much difference. There's a new W11 variant with more power, so you can read more about that on our article in the website. This one produces 155 PS, and now we'll just give you a look into the interiors of the car. Major difference is this new tan upholstery, which now comes with this quilted stitching. Sort of mimics the design of more upmarket cars, and does a fairly decent job, I guess. And there's this illuminated sill plate also, which is a nice touch. The trim is now a dark trim with black interiors. The front of the car doesn't change a lot. The front center console is largely similar. The only change being this new piano black finish, which most car makers now are using as a distinguishing factor. And you also have a smartwatch integration feature, which we put up an Instagram post about it, and so you can just check our Instagram page to see how that works. Other than that, this is largely lifted off the earlier car. Prices for this car start at 12.32 lakhs for the lowest level of the diesel car. There are five diesel variants, one of which is an optional pack, and then there's also a petrol variant which is sold separately. And the engine is the diesel engine is a 2.2 litre diesel it's lifted from the earlier car, but the top trim now has 155 PS, and you can read more about that, like I said earlier, on our website and other social media. So we'll take a few questions now that you have. This car, Raghu Ram, this car hasn't been tested globally for NCAP because this is a largely, this particular car is the Indian spec version, so it hasn't been tested globally for NCAP, but it follows the sort of industry standard of the top trims having 6 airbags, ABS and traction control and all of those features. So it's reasonably safe. Yeah. Yeah, so Shreyas Shenoy, we'll put up a comparer with this and the Innova on our website, so you have a better idea of how these two compare. And Ram Harish Mehr, I'll just focus into the headlines like you asked for, and then you'll have a better idea of how this LED strip goes and the slight reprofiling of the lights. Hi Balasubramaniam, the third row seating is, because this is only a facelift with no structural changes, the third row seats remain unchanged, so the space is at best adequate for third row occupants. Hi, Abhinav. Yes, it has a sunroof, but it's not panoramic and it's just for the front part of it. Sibkatullah, the interior quality is unchanged, so it's sort of mid, like you can't call it very good and it's not very bad either. Yes, it has Apple, you can, it has Android Auto, and but you can connect your, you can connect your Apple phone to your the smartwatch that we spoke about. So yeah, your phone is compatible with this. The on-road. Yeah, hi Rudra. Yeah, that's exactly what we said. It is available in turbocharged 2.2 petrol and diesel options. Hi. Achu, the on-road price, we don't, we'll tell you, you can check our websites for continuous updates on the on-road price of this car. But it'll get a slight premium over the earlier car. Swadesh, hi. You can check our, I just spoke about the price earlier, so you can check about that on our website. So, yeah, Apple CarPlay, you can connect. Shreyas, you can connect your phone to it. So this sort of sums up what the car looks like, and we'll and stay tuned to Overdrive for a lot more coverage of this. We'll put up a first drive video soon, so which will cover most of the queries that you're making right now. Yeah, so that's it for now from here. So if you, for all other details about price, variance, features and anything else related to this, just follow our website and we'll keep you updated about everything that you need to know about the new XUV500. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.